Masyadong marili lang palang ang Tagalog.
When you say the adjective, it looks like it is connected with a particle, so you don't really pause long. Masyadong madali lang palang Tagalog.
Masyadong marili lang palang ang Tagalog.
Okay, Carlo. Please repeat. Masyadong madali lang palang Tagalog.
Masyadong madali ang palang Tagalog.
Masyadong madali lang pala ang Tagalog.
Masyadong madali lang pala Tagalog.
Maliwanag ba? Is that clear to everyone?
Emil.
Yes, sir.
Sorry, I'm so a little lost with the rule for the particles. It's one syllable plus the second syllable?
No, it's one syllable, which means we have one syllable, like you say lang, na, ba, in. Two syllables means when you do like
yata. Right.
Pala, one, two. Or naman, one, two. That's two syllables.
Oh. Yeah.
Okay, let's try card. Okay. Let's repeat. Okay. Malinis, clean, right?
Oh.
I think the house is clean.
Oh, translate it.
I think the house is clean.
Yata malinis ang bahay?
You do not begin with a partner. You begin with a comma.
Oh, yeah. Malinis yata ang bahay?
Malinis yata ang bahay. The house is already clean. One more time, Carlo.
The house is already clean. Malinis lang ang bahay?
The word for already in our previous week is na.
Oh, na, yeah.
Malinis
na lang ang bahay?
I'm just saying one, already.
Na.
Right. So, malinis na ang bahay.
Oh, malinis na ang bahay.
I think the house is already clean.
Malinis yata ang bahay.
Carlo, I use two parts. I think and already. What is the order?
Okay. Malinis na yata ang bahay. Got it. Yeah, okay. That's the order. Oh, hello? That's the order. Oh, okay.
Let's put a qualifier. I think the house is clean already. Carlos, let's complete the pattern.
I think the house is already clean. Clean already? I think the house is very clean. Hold on, let me write this down first.
You just have to follow the pattern, this is the only whiteboard.
I think.
Masyadong
malinis na yata ang bahay.
Maliwanag ba, Carlo?
Yes, yes, yes.
The particle, you always begin with the qualifier. If no qualifier, you begin with the topic.
Got it.
The topic, that's the English rule.
Okay.
Teaching, hello. Adobo is delicious.
Adobo is delicious. Masala ang adobo?
Very good.
Masalap ang adobo.
Surprising adobo.
Sa pais.
When we are surprised, what part of the meal?
Masalap pala ang adobo?
Correct.
Opo.
If you say, really, adobo is delicious. Surprisingly.
Really? With dili is... Really is talagang, right? Talagang. So, talagang masalap ang adobo.
When you are surprised, you have to look for the part of the thing that you feel surprised, that is pala. Now, that is correct. Since you have to give justice to it. Said, really, adobo is delicious.
Talagang masarap pala ang adobo. Talagang masarap. Talagang masarap para ang adobo.
Very good. Let's try one more time. Talagang masarap para ang adobo.
Talagang masarap para ang adobo.
That's very good.
Opo.
Talagang masarap para ang adobo.
Talagang masarap para ang adobo.
Okay.
Opo.
The house is big, Kevin.
Malaki ang bahay.
The house might be big.
Malaki baka malaki ang bahay.
Baka malaki ang bahay.
Baka malaki ang bahay.
Okay. The house is certainly big.
Siguradong malaki ang bahay.
Right. Siguradong malaki ang bahay. Sir, the house is certainly big. When you use the word sir or mom, that is equivalent to po or ho. You don't actually use the term. One or the other, I don't know what you do. What you can po or you can po. Okay. Sir, the house is big.
Talagang malaki po ang bahay.
Sir, the house is really big.
Sir, the house is really big. Talagang malaki po ang bahay.
The house is just small.
The house is just small.
It's only small.
The house is only small. The house is only small. Maliit lang ang bahay.
Sir, the house is only small.
Maliit lang po ang bahay.
Although you are using two single partners, lang po a priority part. So, maliit lang po ang bahay. Clear?
Opo.
Okay. Any problem? Not me. May problema ba? Naintindihan niyo ba? Ang simple structure na pinag-aralan natin nung isang meeting.
It's good.
Oo.
Ano ba naman po?
Opo.
Opo.
Thank you.